Hello, I'm Dr. Neil Schultz. And welcome to DermTV. Sunburns, they just happen. They happen to you, they happen to me. Despite our best efforts, it's not the end of the world, but they just happen. So what can we do to make our skin feel better and recover faster from sunburns? First and most important, not only get out of the sun, obviously, but go indoors, because any place outside, you're still going to be hit by the reflected rays, the reflected burning rays of the sun that come off sand, water, the beach, walls. And if you can't get indoors, then at least try to get into your car, because you won't get burned through the glass in the car. So you have a sunburn. Is it a regular, red, irritated, annoying sunburn, which is a first degree burn, or do you have a second degree burn, which means you have blisters? Most of us get regular sunburns, so let's talk about first degree sunburns first. For relief from that burning, gnawing sensation, aspirin is a wonderful drug, and if you can't take aspirin, then take a non-steroidal like Aleve or Advil. Secondly, use milk and water compresses topically on the skin, which goes a long way towards relieving that really annoying burning sensation. The evaporation of the milk and water causes a cooling sensation, and the protein in the milk buffers that irritated skin and makes it feel much better. Apply cortisone ointments 3 or 4 times a day. Ointments, not creams, because the ointments, while they're a little bit thicker and they come in a Vaseline base, a little bit messier, but they prevent a chilly sensation and they work much better. If the sunburn is over a widespread area of your body, then you probably want to take a bath, not a shower. The pressure of the shower water hurts. So in a bath, use cool or lukewarm water, not ice cold water. And lastly, afterwards, pat your skin dry. Don't rub it dry, just pat it dry. Aloe vera is very good for burns and will also help your skin feel better. Lastly, avoid topical anesthetics like benzocaine, lanocaine, lidocaine. Also avoid the topical antihistamines. Benadryl cream also can create irritation like the topical anesthetics. But what happens if your sunburn is more than just red, irritated skin? What if it starts to get some fluid in it and you actually get blisters? Then you have a second degree burn. And besides doing all the things we just discussed for your first degree burn, the most important thing for a second degree burn, do not pop the blisters, because that's the way they get infected. Instead, treat them with topical compresses. This time, instead of milk and water, get Burroughs solution from the pharmacy, available without a prescription, and then apply a topical antibiotic ointment like bacitracin or polysporin after the compresses. There comes a certain point, though, where your sunburn may require medical attention. So if you have a fever of over 101, if you have chills, nausea, vomiting, dizziness, or if your sunburn is actually getting worse after the first 12 hours, these are all signs that you need medical attention. So while I hope it doesn't happen to you and I hope you don't get a sunburn, now you know how to take care of it and how to feel more comfortable. Please join me again at DermTV.com. If you have a question, please send it to me by visiting DermTV.com/question. I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and thank you for watching today.